Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and this video is my response to a viewer's question about how to make negative pattern brushes, text, and logos in Adobe Illustrator. And if I understood the ask correctly, then demonstrating how I created the designs you see here on my artboard will answer the question. Now, spoiler alert, I'm not going to actually be making negative pattern brushes. That, to my knowledge, isn't possible, but I'm going to show you how to get this effect, and I think that's going to be just as good. It's going to work with pattern brushes, with text, and with logos. When you create a pattern brush you plan to use like this, I recommend you use simple design elements and leave a little space around each one so that every element has its own drop shadow. It's just going to make for a more distinct effect. Each piece of the design is going to need a dark fill color. I usually use black and no stroke attached to it. And that's going to make it easier to work with when you're creating that negative space effect. I'm going to move to a different document and show you how I created these designs. Now, as I said, I want to leave a little space in between each one of the design elements, and I do that by using a bounding box. And even though I've already created my pattern brushes, I'm going to make one of them over again to show you how the bounding box works. So I'll just click on this ellipse and hold the Option key down to drag out a copy, and I'll create a bounding box, which is an invisible rectangle that sits on the layer behind the design element. I'll click on the artboard to deselect the design and get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and click to open the rectangle dialog box. And I'm going to use the measurements for the bounding box here. I'll type in 1.75 and tab down and type in 0.8 and then say OK. Now I've ended up with a black rectangle, and this has got to be invisible. So I'll come to the Properties panel and remove the fill color, click on the artboard to close the Swatches panel, and then get the Selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and select the bounding box and the design. Come over to the Properties panel, and in the Align area, I'll click on Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center. And then I've got to move the bounding box behind the layer that has the ellipse on it. We can't see layers on the artboard, but we can go over to the Layers panel. I'll twirl this open, and I can see the rectangle bounding box, which is selected, and the ellipse, which is selected. And the way layers work in Illustrator is the layer that is on top in the list of layers is going to be in front on the artboard. So I've got to move the rectangle underneath the ellipse so that it's behind it on the artboard. So I can either grab hold of it and drag it down underneath the ellipse, or I could use the keyboard shortcut Shift Command Left Bracket. And now the bounding box will show Illustrator how much space to leave on the right side and on the left side as it repeats this pattern over and over again for my pattern brush. Then with the brushes panel open, if I hadn't already created the pattern brush, I would come down to the bottom bar and click on the new brush icon and create it that way. If you want more information on the actual process of creating pattern brushes, I have a whole series of tutorials, and I'll leave a link to that series at the end of this video. And one last thing before I delete my ellipse design. If you're wondering how I got the pointed ends, I used the anchor point tool, which is Shift C. And what I did was I just came over and clicked on the left and the right anchors, and that's how I made my points. Now I'm going to get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and delete this design. Now I'm not going to go through the process of creating the circle pattern brush because I used that same process, and you've got the measurements here. So now I'll move to the Layers panel and reveal the layer that has some circle templates already set up. I have an 8-inch circle, a 6-inch circle, and a 4-inch circle. I'm going to apply a color to the outside circle. I'll select it and get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and click on my color sample, and then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard to deselect it. Now I'll apply the pattern brushes to these other circles. I'll move back to the brushes panel, select the 6-inch circle, and click on this leaves pattern brush, and then select the 4-inch circle and apply the circles pattern brush. Then I'll come over and select my text and hold down the Option key and drag it over to the right. And notice that the word joy is hidden by this circle, and that's because it's on a different layer. So I'll go to the Layers panel. I can see that my copy is selected here, and I need to place it in the layer that my circles are in. So I'll twirl this open so I can get a better look. I'm going to select this joy and just drag it up and place it at the top of the list, and now you're able to see it. So let's move it down here in the center, and then I'll select the circles, the pattern brush, and the text. Move over to the Properties panel, and in the Align area, I'll click on Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center. Now these are lined up perfectly, but before I can go any further, I've got to make some adjustments. So I'll click on the artboard to deselect everything and select just the word joy. Go back to the Properties panel, and in the Quick Actions area, I'm going to click on Create Outlines. Then I'll select my circles pattern brush, hold down the Shift key so I can also select my leaves pattern brush, and go up to Object, down to Expand Appearance, and click here. Now once again, I'll select everything and get the Shape Builder tool, keyboard shortcut Shift M. And to remove the pieces I don't want, I hold down the Option key and just click on them. I'm going to speed the video up, but when you do this, keep the Option key pressed down and take your time so that you only click on the individual pieces that you actually want to remove. Now I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard to deselect the design. Right now, it just looks like I have white pattern brushes and white text, but when I select the design and go up to Effect, down to Stylize, and click on Drop Shadow, it immediately takes on a completely different look. I'm going to leave the mode set to Multiply, Opacity at 75%, and the X and Y offset and the blur all at 0.0417 inches. Now I have a black color selected. If you want to choose a different color for your drop shadow, click on the black and you can choose whatever color you want. I'm going to leave it at black, so I'll just say OK and OK, and then click on the artboard to deselect the design so you can see the final product. And that has turned out really nice. And again, I believe it's because the design elements are simple and there's a little space in between each one of them. Now I'm going to move back to the Layers panel and hide the layer that has the circles on it. And we're going to work on our logo next. I'll grab hold of the logo, hold down the Option key to make a copy. And the first thing I want to do is enlarge it. So I'll go up to Object, Transform, Scale, and I'm going to type in 300% and say OK. Now earlier I said it's important with the pattern brush to use a solid fill and no stroke, and the same really applies for logos. However, this logo was created a long time ago and it does have strokes, so I'm going to work on it just a little bit before I move on. Now I've already converted the text to outlines, so I'm not concerned about those, but the first thing I'll do with everything selected is go up to Object and click on Expand. I'm going to make sure fill and stroke are checked and say OK. Now the logo has been grouped, so to ungroup it, I'll use the keyboard shortcut Shift Command G, and then I'll click on the artboard to deselect the entire design and select just the leaves and the branches. Now, because I expanded the appearance, I'm going to be able to join both the stroke and the fill colors. So with those selected, I'll go to the properties panel, come down to the Pathfinder area, and I'm going to click on the click to unite icon, and that should take care of uniting the strokes and the fill color, and that's going to be so much easier to work with. Now I'll select the design and regroup it, keyboard shortcut command G, and then move over to the layers panel and reveal my logo template. And once again, I've got a design element that's got to be moved to a different layer so it can go in front of the template. So I'll grab hold of the group layer and just drag it up to the top of the list in the logo template layer. And I'll select both the design and the template and go back over to the properties panel and click on horizontal align center and vertical align center. And then so I can see what I'm doing, I'll select the rectangle, get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and then sample the color to change the background. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and select the rectangle and the design. Then I'll get the zoom tool, keyboard shortcut Z, and zoom in a little bit so that I can see what I'm doing. And then with everything selected, I'll get the shape builder tool, keyboard shortcut Shift M. Then just like before, I'll speed the video up, but I'm going to hold the option key down and just click all of the places that I want to remove from the design. And the reason this is so easy is because I united the strokes and the fill color a minute ago. Now these letters are pretty skinny, and you've got to be very careful not to hit the background when you're punching them out. That's why I like to use a larger or a bolder font, but when you're working with logos, sometimes you're not going to have that choice. So just take it slow and be careful. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. I'm going to zoom back out, keyboard shortcut Command 0. Then I'll go up to Effect, down to Stylize, and choose Drop Shadow. Now the openings in the logo are smaller than they were in our previous design, so I'm going to reduce the drop shadow. I'm going to change the opacity to 35%, and I'll change the offset on both of these to 0.02 and the blur to 0.02. I'll leave black as the color and say OK, and click on the artboard so you can see the final result. Now I'll move back to our previous document where you can see both of the designs side by side. And I believe this is a great look for logos and for different objects that are using pattern brushes. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I appreciate the question from the viewer. It has motivated me to make this tutorial and to maybe even use this method in some of my future projects. I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.